Welcome to today's brunch. Today we are making something that I cannot believe we've never made before. We are making Eggs Benedict. And I'm really excited. It's actually pretty easy. Okay, medium easy. It's medium easy. Anyway, it's going to be delicious, and let's get started with our breakfast cocktail. Okay guys, so for today's breakfast cocktail, we are going to make an orange and gin fizz. Okay, so take your shaker filled with ice, and add 3 to 4 ounces of gin. Next, add about 1 ounce of Cointreau or another kind of orange liqueur. Next, let's add about 6 ounces of orange juice. Okay, now shake all of that together. Get 2 glasses and fill them with ice. Remember, we like big glasses because they fit more inside them. Split the mixture between the 2 glasses. And then to make this a fizz, we are going to top it with some ginger ale. Give those a stir. And now we have our orange and gin fizzes. Okay guys, now that we have our orange and gin fizz, we can continue making brunch. The first thing we're gonna do for brunch today is cook a side of bacon because I really like bacon and I wanna eat bacon with our Eggs Benedict. So put some bacon on the stove. So we're gonna cook the bacon over medium heat until it is really nice and crispy. And if you don't like bacon, you can have a side salad with Eggs Benedict or really whatever you want, but I like crispy bacon. You guys, let's go look at what's going on in the living room.
I have 2 very lazy boys. They live with me.
Okay, once your bacon looks perfectly crispy like this, take it off and put it onto a paper towel. Okay guys, now it is time for the Eggs Benedict. And if you don't know what Eggs Benedict is, it is an English muffin with Canadian bacon, a poached egg, and hollandaise sauce. There's a lot of eggs, a lot of butter, gonna be really delicious. Obviously, if there's a lot of eggs and a lot of butter, it's going to be delicious. Okay, so you guys, the only thing we really need to make for this brunch is a hollandaise sauce. And hollandaise is basically egg yolks, butter, and lemon juice. And that's it. It's really not that complicated, but the process to make it is a little complicated because you have to have it absorb the butter and you have to heat it just right so the eggs don't start to cook. So I'm gonna walk you through how I do that. So first I'm gonna put my big pan with water on the stove for our poached eggs, but we are also gonna use this to make the hollandaise because I'm really lazy and I don't have a double boiler and we're gonna need this hot water anyway, so that's what we're gonna use. So salt your water and turn it on to medium high heat. Okay, next we're gonna need a bowl to make the hollandaise in. I'm using this metal bowl because the heat will come through when I put it over this pan. And I've cleaned it really, really well on the outside because it's gonna be sitting in the water that we eventually poach our eggs in. And again, if you have a double boiler, use that. You can also do it right on the stove if you're very, very careful. But again, I'm lazy and I need this anyway, so we're gonna do this. Okay, next, to my bowl for the hollandaise, I'm going to add 3 egg yolks. And when you add the egg yolks, you just want to pass the egg yolk back and forth between the shells until you have only the yolk remaining, and then put that in the bowl. Okay, so we've got our 3 egg yolks, and next we're gonna add about 1 tablespoon of lemon juice. I like my hollandaise really lemony, so I'm gonna see what I get out of 1/2 a lemon, and if I need to add a little more, I'm gonna do that. Remember, we want this to be extremely smooth, so everything gets added just a little bit at a time. You wanna stir up the eggs and the lemon until it starts to look a little bit thick. Next, I have melted about 1/2 stick of butter. Yeah. So, we want to carefully drizzle the butter inside the bowl and continuously whisk it so it emulsifies. But we also want to be careful not to cook the eggs with our hot melted butter that we have. So So I'm going to do this very slowly and very carefully. Okay, now that we have added our half a stick of melted butter, it is time to heat this up and thicken it a little bit. Okay, so I'm going to hold the bowl over the poached egg hot water, which is not quite boiling, which is what we want, and I'm going to continuously whisk the hollandaise until it is really thickened up. But you have to be really careful because you don't want to cook the eggs. So if you think the eggs are cooking, you need to remove it from the heat. That's why I like this method, because I have a lot more control over removing it from the heat and putting it back. So just leave it over the heat and whisk it up until it's really thick. Okay, I think that looks pretty good. And we are gonna stir in a pinch or so of cayenne pepper and some salt. That looks like a really nice hollandaise. Okay, so now we wanna keep the hollandaise warm. We wanna keep it at least at room temperature. So I'm just gonna take a bowl and fill it with hot water from my faucet and just rest the bowl right inside to keep it warm. Okay, so now my hollandaise is just resting in hot water until we need it, and we're ready to finish brunch. That was the hard part, by the way. I know that was a lot of whisking. My wrist is kind of tired, but we're almost done, so it will all be worth it in the end. I'm going to turn the toaster on for the English muffins, which is gonna take about 5 minutes, and the heat on for the Canadian bacon, and then we'll do the eggs.
Tubbs marmalade over here won't leave me alone.
Oh, he's my baby.
It smells.
Stop, he doesn't smell. Give me him.
He's smelling.
His name is not Tubbs Marmalade. We always wash our hands after touching animals in the kitchen. Okay, let's start poaching the eggs. So we're going to crack all 4 eggs into a strainer over a cup and try to get that like watery white out so that we're just left with a really nice thick white and the yolk. So you just want to heat up the Canadian bacon, so when it's cooked on one side, flip it over to the other. I think our English muffins are done. So we have our English muffins on the plate. Those are finished. And next we're going to take our Canadian bacon and put one on each English muffin.
Looks pretty good.
So I'm taking each egg out with a slotted spoon, putting it on top of the Canadian bacon. So now we're gonna take a spoon and we're gonna spoon the hollandaise over each egg. And for the last thing, I like to top mine with a little sprinkle of paprika over each one. And that's it, guys. Now we have our delicious Eggs Benedict. We made it. We did it. And now we get to eat it. Okay, guys, so we're ready to have brunch. And it looks really good. I'm very excited. So is Brandon. And we're gonna eat our brunch now, our delicious Eggs Benedict with our homemade hollandaise sauce.
Not okay.
Thanks for having brunch with us, guys. And hopefully we'll see you on the next brunch.